So thank you very much for hosting us this night. So I'm going to, or we are going to tell you a little bit about our journey with Angular within Vestiaire Collective. So for those who doesn't know yet what is and who we are actually a worldwide community and marketplace for luxury lovers. So we are inviting people that have luxury goods to resell it on our marketplace. So it's a C2C, mainly a C2C marketplace. We are almost everywhere, or we have an international footprint, but we are really focusing on Europe, US and Australia, and we have offices open in all those countries. So we are an international company already. Vestiaire exists since 2009. We are leading the European European market for second-hand luxury goods, and we are looking forward to lead the international market. We are around 300 employees as of today, and 45 in the IT teams, but we are hiring very much in the IT team. So if you are interested by my presentation and what we are doing at Vestiaire Collective, don't hesitate to go visit on our site and see what are the opening positions at our company. So now that you know who is Vestiaire Collective, let's go a little bit deeper in why we are here tonight. So as I said, Vestiaire is existing exists since 2009. It has been a startup as many companies, and the developer started building a proprietary platform on top of the languages that they were knowing at those time. We really optimized this platform based on what we are doing and the complex workflow at Vestiaire Collective. But unfortunately, now this platform is a little bit old, and the framework that have been used, or the known framework that have been used, are not really the most fashionable framework today. We've also started implementing responsive technology, but it was somehow responsive. So you can, for those who are really technical, you can see on the site it's not that responsive. And also our business evolved. We introduced new practices, new services, new workflows, and those have to be had to be implemented within the platform. And it's becoming more and more complicated for us to really reflect the complexity and the variety of things and services that we are providing to our users. So we definitely need not a new platform, but a better platform, because the current platform is answering quite well to most of our needs. But still, we really are facing some issues that will be more and more complicated to fix in the future. So we started a project of recasting our whole platform. So a platform request, seriously. So this is exactly what my top management told me when I told them that we are going to enter into that project of recasting our platform, because in their mind it was a 2 or 3 years process, and nothing would be delivered in the meantime or meanwhile, which is not the case, of course. So yeah, we are recasting our platform, but not anyhow. We first need to have a clear vision of the targeted platform. So I've said a clear vision of the targeted platform. And basically what we want to achieve is moving from a monolithic platform that includes everything, the front, the back, the tools for the internal team, the tools for the services for the end users, to something that is that looks more like this, which is a set of micro or macro services, a proper middleware that expose all those content and all those services to the front end, and then several front-end channel, which are basically the website that we provide and expose to the user through the internet, but also the back office that we expose to our internal team and the iOS and Android application. We also need a clear execution plan, so we are not doing everything simultaneously. We will start by something that is the most easy to start with, which is the front end. So we are redesigning the front end platform and properly exposing our business layers through a new API middleware. Then we will test it, of course, release it live, and then we will start recasting the back end layer, but not everything at the time, more identifying which are the business layers that are prioritized, that are the top priority of moving to a new to new technology, and then testing and iterating, so on and so on, so forth and so forth, to finally and eventually reach a point where our whole platform will be hosted by new technologies. And of course, this is where Algolia really is a big partner, because we've been working with Algolia since almost the beginning. They have provided us with our search engine that we expose to our web and application users. And of course, redesigning the front-end platform means also reintegrating Algolia within our platform and better integrating it compared to what we are doing today. And of course, we need an amazing team, which fortunately we have. And by the way, we are hiring, so don't forget about that. So buckle up, we are taking off. So how we choose the right technology? So why did we choose Angular? First, we defined what's required and what's necessary for our recast. So we need to achieve better performance. We need to be better at SEO. We need a platform that proves sufficient maintainability and that is backed by someone that makes sure that we can rely on this platform for a long term. We need documentation, so we need a documented platform with a community strong enough to be able to make us or to accompany us developing the new platform, and we need a platform that is somehow mature, so we cannot afford to discover and to debug a platform and to participate to the open source community if we really would like to do this, but we have a business to run as well, so we need a mature platform. Secondly, we really wanted to involve everyone into this recast. So we hosted several inner internal hackathons with the technical team to really let the team come up with the best solution for our new front end platform. Our objective or our message to the team was really focus on the goal that we want to achieve in terms of what's required here, not on the technology. So use any kind of technology that you think is the best suited for our needs, and prove us that this technology really will answer what's our criteria. And then we had to make a decision eventually. So really, fantasy aside, I'm not saying that Ruby and C is a fantasy language. They are really pretty good language, but in the team we don't have the skills to develop on those language. So we left those aside. We also choose not to stay in our comfort zone. So the legacy platform is built on top of PHP, but we decided to try to figure out something that would better answer our requirements. And then we choose Angular versus React, so the two last framework that was in final, because we really thought that Angular, since it's a all-in-one framework, it's a turnkey solution, would be much easier for the team to be onboarded on, and achieving the calendar and the agenda that was pretty ambitious that we set up for the request, we felt more confident with Angular than with React, which is more, from our point of view, a lot of different libraries that, when you know them and you have the time to pick the right one for your needs, are working pretty well and are pretty performant. But when you don't have the time and when you need to go fast, are maybe a show blocker to actually implement and to migrate a front-end platform. So this is why we choose the Angular over React. So of course we faced some issue because on the paper it was all great, and during the hackathons it was very, very nice and very fine, and we managed to do things very easily. But then when we entered the real development, it was another story. So Angular wasn't really or wasn't finally that straightforward, especially for a team that worked on other technologies before and that had another philosophy of doing and building front-end applications. So what we found out is that there are several ways of achieving a goal, with all of those having pros and cons. So you have to find the best way that answer properly your requirements. So what we found out is that when you are not used to use a framework like Angular, it's not straightforward to go on this framework. So you have there is a learning curve that is not negligible to take into account. At the beginning of the project, we kind of discovered all the possibility to start the project, so we had to reboot it several times because we found out that the different possibility we were using were not properly answering our requirements or our needs. And then there is still a question about the maturity of the ecosystem, and even today we still are facing some significant changes between two versions of the same platform or even Angular, which are not backward compliant, of course, because it would be too easy, and that requires to spend time to rework part of our platform, which is also kind of frustrating for the developers. So the other thing that we found out is, wait, Instant Search is not available for Angular. So this was a discovery a surprise when we started working on Angular. It was not a good surprise actually, but I must say that Algolia was very supportive and integrated the development of this library, of this SDK, in their roadmap, and I've been able to deliver a first version of this SDK in a very short timing, so that was really helpful. We were also facing the SSR issue that Max shared with us earlier, so we partnered with Algolia to figure out a solution to work around this issue, and the default widget that was provided with the SDK was not properly answering our needs neither. Again, Algolia was very supportive, and they iterated and released a version of the SDK that allowed us to integrate and to inject custom widgets very easily. So this issue has been fixed in almost no time, which was quite a relief for us, because we were counting very much on Algolia, and we know that now that we can still continue counting on them, which is great. And then the other question that we or issue it was not really an issue. It was more a question and a kind of thing that you that you encounter anyway when you are working on such kind of simple single app API is how do we sync our components with our server? So of course we use the very famous Redux design pattern, which as in React is not a default integrated pattern within the framework. So you have to reintegrate it within the framework. And basically, it's even if Angular is a very good framework, Redux or the implementing this design pattern is necessary to make sure that we have a clear architecture that can be easily maintained and that evolve easily without having to re-implement or redo the implementation of injecting data into each component. So basically, the phrase that Jonathan used to say is we are managing our data into the store that is clever and all our components are completely dumb because they are not knowing anything about the data and how to collect it. It's all managed by the store and the different services that the store calls. And we even worked on optimizing the concept. So our, I've mentioned our middleware API. We are generating this API through Swagger, which is a great framework for actually defining the content of the API and then automatically generating the code underneath. And we leverage Swagger to actually automatically build a custom SDK that we inject into our platform, our front-end platform, and this automatic custom SDK actually takes away from developers all the issues about what are the data, how to collect them, in which API shall we look for those data. Everything is wrapped into this custom SDK, and the front-end developer just have to build the component and refer to the proper data, and updating the data is done automatically and by magic by this SDK. So Jonathan will be happy to talk about it later on because he worked on it, and I think he can be quite proud of this achievement. So now that we faced, so those are the main issues or blocking point that we faced during the development. So we started the development back in October 2017, and now we are almost ready for landing. The architecture is now stabilized, so we have a proper architecture that is working. And actually, the team is able to now fix the new issues in almost no time, which means that we've came to a point where the front-end platform is quite mature for our needs and for our developers. The whole development team is onboarding on the technology. So in 5 months, we have 10-20 developers that now knows properly about the framework and how to use it, which also means that for people coming from PHP, it's quite easy to be onboarded on this kind of framework because it's the approach is quite close to a standard PHP framework. So that is also a good news because it means that we've selected a framework that will enable us to easily onboard the new developers into the team. Instant Search Angular SDK is really working like a charm, and actually it's really impressive because when we are doing demo at the end of our sprints, all the stakeholders and the people are participating to the demo are really impressed about the speed and the performance of the search engine, especially compared to what we have today. So it's really an achievement for us also, and we are really proud to have worked with Angular for this, some figures. And we will be live very soon, so keep a close eye on vestiairecollective.com. If you are part of a happy few, we will see the new version of our front end in the coming weeks, if not days. And that's it for me. So thank you very much for listening to me.
It's me. I'm back with the box. Does anybody have any questions for the team from Vestiaire Collective? Don't be shy. Yes. And see, we get to throw it. Look, it's fun.
Thank you. Whatever the framework or the non-framework that we use, be it Vanilla, React, Angular, we usually end up having performance issues because the page is complex, because we have so many components. Did you experience any performance issue? And if so, what tools or what tips or Chrome extension did you use to fix them? Tu peux répondre en français.
Pour Angular? Yeah. Non, on n'a pas vraiment eu de problème de performance. Enfin, on a fait un test sur React. Les deux étaient significatifs. C'était bien en fait en niveau perf, mais
ouais, to be totally transparent, for the time being, we haven't experienced any performance issue. So we are coming from far. So compared to what we have today, we are improving a lot our user experience. Once the site will be released, we will continue figuring this out, but no, for the time being, we are just integrating the SDK as is, and we are quite satisfied about the performance, both on the website and on the application side.
Anyone else? Don't be afraid of the box.
And you can ask in French.
Okay, well then, to give it up for the team from Vestiaire Collective, Jean-Ton and Patrick.
Thank you.